Greetings, I'm Devane, and welcome back to Let's Play Heroes of Might and Magic. Yes. We left it at the end of our turn on day one, because I lost track of time and where we were. We're now in a very strong position, as we're actually fighting in the barbarian homeland through the pass, having conquered the desert and got our own land, and basically we want to try and keep control of the two crystal mines that we know of, so that the barbarians can't actually get their cyclops out. That way, when we kill their cyclops, that's it. They've got no more. Once they've run out, they're out. For now, we will see, because we have... we're doing relatively well. Let's go over there and see. We're there. The guarding. Yeah, we could do that. Take the sorceress in and maybe take the... Because I think there's a town over here, by the looks of it, which they're coming from. So, the only way to deal with it is to go and beat them up. Oh my, very impressive range of spells. What do I mean? Whoa! Teleport. And in addition to teleport, I heard resurrect. So, basically, my paladins pretty much hopefully going to be making it through most of these battles now. Unless, of course, I killed them all early, in which case it doesn't matter. Can I get you to come over here? Because we're just trying to explore right now. You can... we'll see what we've got. Four more cyclopses? Yeah. Because we're doing pretty well here. May not have the zounds that they have, but that doesn't matter because we've got genies. And I think you'll find that's pretty much fully built. Apart from the shipyard, because the shipyard tends to come down here. You have to have the town by the water after that. So yeah, you won't get anything here other than shipyard. It tends to be in places like this. So that's more or less what a fully built town, barbarian town, looks like. Horde lot pack. Meteor shower looks like. Basically, it covers an area of 3x3. And we go in. We did a lot of damage. Oh. because we're quick. I mean, the genie won't last as such, because we've not really got a way to refill them, but once they're gone, we can always use Bless, Curse, Blind, Lightning Bolts, Resurrect. Resurrected the genies, there we go. Once they're gone, was the plan to put it there. For some reason, because of you can't actually look to group a through an enemy that's 2 tiles too big, so it doesn't really matter. Down 22! Yes! There you go, we halve the stack. So, we lost 6 genies. But our genies, they did good. Considering we're basically just sitting in defense at the moment. To get me involved in playing with the Pathfinder Adventure Card game. So, and so much so, I bought the old Rise of the Rune Lord set. Finish up, there we go. Where's your castle? So, we'll go back. There we go, it should be done. Yes, we're seeing you off of the Overage Explorers. We can, basically. We're really happy. Oh, hello. I wonder how we're going to do this. Unless I. It's terrible. I'm sorry, did you have castle walls defending you? Bit of a shame, really. Bye. There we go. We'll just send the paladins in and start carving them up. I mean, even though you don't start with magic as a knight, and it's always worth maybe taking the time to meteor shower. It's always worth taking the time. To invest in them when you can. It's not a big deal for the Nyans, but it comes in handy when you've got it. And once you start getting magic, well, basically, you're going to see just how awesome it is. Get that annoying. See, now I could use, like, say, Storm, but for example, the amount of damage it's going to do to me compared to killing all the peasants, it's just not worth it. I'd literally overkill myself and cause more damage to me than they ever could. So, but if I was doing a last stand, for example, in Overwhelm, then Storm might be a good way of leveling the playing field for the next people who are going to be building doing their defense. So it's a very defensive spell, despite the fact that it's not, because you're not just thinking about whether you're going to win or lose the battle, but it's an effect on the war. And that's what we've got here. Yes. It's going to be slow because literally apart from this town up there, that's good to know. Literally apart from the barbarian and the knight with the mobility stuff, we're actually kind of just dragging through the snow right now. It's kind of showing off the way the barbarians have pathfinding, so it's all on rough terrain, so that they can make the most out of that ability. In all honesty. Yes. Shift you over, yes. Keep your new knowledge. Make a scroll. Former scroll. Power axe, dragon sword. Okay, we'll leave you there. Not really much point in doing anything at the moment. But we're just gonna take it easy. Increase morale, come in here and attack these. Finish off these guys until we get to basically Lord Slayer, and then. And you can see, like, they'll have like 200 Cyclopses or something ridiculous. I was like, well, how did you get that? And it's like, well, because he's not actually gone out and fought, like, level 20 and all the insane stuff like that. So, what? So, 20 Cyclopses there. Fuel and Dimension Door and View Heroes. Okay. That's worth having, because when we can do this, and we'll see View Heroes, View All. And yes, you can see everything now. We'll notice the dark expanse of the desert is there. They've got 6 castles, we've conquered 4 of them. And I've got two more here with one hero coming out. And here's where all their mines are, and a gold mine. So by the looks of it, I can try and conquer one of these, because I don't know which one is going to be Castle Slayer. But I'll find out soon enough. I think it might be... I think. So, but yeah, that's worth seeing. It's a nice little pocket in there. Ooh. Except you don't get there, so there's no way to get in here, so I'm not sure I can tell. It's just an area where they left where they didn't do the map. Fair enough. I mean, I prefer old games to newer games, especially with the setup that I've got, because, as you know, I like to go through franchises. As for my style, well, it depends on the game, really. I tend to play it on the easiest, because I enjoy the story more than anything else, because especially like puzzle games and strategy games and stuff like that. But I'm not above having to change for it to increase. For example, there's no difficulty slider here, and even on easy, quite a few of the games can still be quite tough. So it's just a case of, well, you know, that's a slightly different to my usual tact, but basically because basically, the fairies would rush up and block the archers. We've got to take them out first. Then, I won't have to worry about them. That was the principle, wasn't it? Still got you. Can always have them come out as a weapon. There's nothing really to defend down there anymore, because they're all going to have to come through. Besides, it's nice to use some different spells. I mean, I know I paralyze for them. Because they're starting troops, and with the setup that I've got, that's not good. Berserker. Right, turns are good against him. But, yeah. But we can cancel that. And he's like, well, they attacked Google. So we can cost him bringing back. So it was literally the platform that took the damage, and only the ones that went berserk in the first place. What's this? Black Fang. Yep, fair enough. They decided to come out and charge because they've got nothing else to do. Why not the Paladins? Well, what you'll have noticed is that they're berserk. They're going to attack the nearest enemy. Fortunately, for them, the nearest area, once I teleported them, was their troops. So, even though I can control who they attacked, they were still able to do damage to their forces. Just good news for me. This is Fundax Castle Slayer. This is the castle that I need to take. How are we doing for money? I've got loads of money. It's day 2, I believe. Fireball Berserker. Then enough crystal to build that, but because they haven't built it yet. Armageddon. That's the Holy Terror strikes the battlefield, causing severe damage to your creatures. So basically, fun was had by all. Okay, I've got come down here. Fundax defenders. Pack Zounds, because it's over 100, over 100, over 50. Pack, I think, is over 25, possibly over 20. So, yeah, that's quite a bit, but compared to what I've got, we're roughly even. We're roughly even, I think, but we've not quite finished what we're doing yet, have we? Because now it might just be worth not having with that, to be honest, but John James is very much good for us. We'll take the others. There's still 10 Cyclopses to go and hurt someone. It might be worthwhile to see exactly what Fundex has got there. Now what we will do, we bring heroes from here. Don't really care who they are. We'll make them all look for change. Because we're using all the money from them castles. It's 1,000 each. So basically fun as they've still got about a higher total army strength, even though we're basically dominant. So I think it's the castle army that's giving them that benefit. Which is why I'm hoping that if I bring enough of these up, then we'll just rush them up. Turn or kill them. It's going to take a while. We might just kill them from that side. We've got a nightmare. Find your spell, but why not? Ain't got one yet, not at all. Basically, it's pretty much game over, but the final battle may be tough. Got nothing in resources that I can do it. I'm just hoping to switch that once I switch the total armor strength to red, I know that I will be able to attack and win the game. So, right now, it doesn't matter so much. And it's a night. I've seen some of these nights before. Because the pool kind of rotates, and if you retreat, then the hero goes to the top of the pool, so you can fire the hero again. But if they are defeated, then they go to, well, they don't go to the top of the pool. They kind of randomly come out. Well, not to the bottom of the pool, because as far as I'm aware. Because you can, I'm not like, it's not like you don't find them in the next turn, but you can probably find them a couple of turns later. So whether they go to the bottom of the top or get shuffled in the middle, I'm not sure. But there we go, that's finally switched to red. Which means if I can get these up quick enough, I will have everything I need to stomp first slayer. So we'll do that. But I don't think Fundex can move. I think it's we'll soon find out, let's see if we can go in into some sort of movement. Lord Kilburn to pick up a few bits and bobs. Simply because it gives our heroes the time to try and get through the desert to Lord Kilburn. Which, given the trackless race, which it essentially is, okay, we can see them, we can see because we have top down view, It may take a couple of turns. In fact, it may even take a whole week. But... so we'll see. Yeah. Pondex can't move. So what I might do is we'll kill them and go to pick some of these up. Just for the sake of it, it's going to take a while, but it's easier for quicker for Lord Kilburn to get there. And it is day 4. Yeah, not moving. Nah, we'll take him. Whoa, okay, maybe not. Pondex, see, that tank is ridiculous. Might be reloading off that because, yes, ridiculousness is. Well, 17 gladiators paid for that. That's not good. There go my paladins, it's good. Yeah. done well. I mean, we got it down to 62 to 7, so... I wouldn't say it's definitely hopeless. I mean, yeah, we'll go complete this up. Could have berserked them, I guess. There we go, Lord Kilbar. We lost 91 knights and 32, but we did defeat 64 psychopaths. They're half the number. And the yellow player has been vanquished. The barbarian castle has been overthrown and their army scattered. Yay! It saved a scenario win number 5. Would you like to start the next scenario? No, I don't think I will. It's been 40 minutes. This has been Divine playing Let's Play Heroes of Might and Magic. I finally defeated scenario 5 of the campaign. Instead of playing blind, so that's probably, this is definitely the furthest I've